last class we discussed about the cell cycle and different phases of the cell cycle, right? Actually, what we discussed in the last class or up to the last class, the part is completely related to the NCRT. The part is completely related to NCRT. See, this topic related to the cell cycle, but okay, this concept is not given in NCRT, but this is also very important topic, sometimes asking bits from this area. But if we studied in NCRT, this concept is not given. Okay, so here, the next concept is cell cycle and checkpoints. Before going to the concept, I like to discuss about the two points here. One is normal cell, other one is cancer cell. One is the normal cell, other one is the cancer cell. So if we think about normal cell and the cancer cell, so what is the difference between normal cell and the cancer cell? See, within normal cell, cell division is occurred by a regulated manner. Cell division occurred in normal cells, regulated manner. All of you remember. See, regulated manner means controlled cell division is takes place in normal cell. Very controlled cell division is takes place in normal cell. See, for the completion of normal cell division, 24 hours required 24 hours. Coming to the cancer cell. Sir, what is cancer cell? In cancer cell, uncontrolled cell division is occurred. Within that cancer cell, uncontrolled cell division is takes place for the completion of one cell division, 1 hour is enough. 1 hour is enough. See, the difference is very, very huge different. In the normal cells, within our body, normal cells are there. For the normal cells, cell division completion requires 24 hours time, but within that cancer cells, whatever the cancer cells are there, the cancer cells, cell division completion requires 1 hour. So that is the huge difference. The point is here, one is controlled cell division, other one is uncontrolled cell division. Uncontrolled cell division is called as cancer. Uncontrolled cell division is called as cancer. Sir, during cell division process, which one is controls or which one is regulated? Which one is regulated? See, during cell division process, in a normal cell, there is a checkpoints are present. These checkpoints are involved in the regulation of cell division. In a normal cell, checkpoints are present. So, during cell division process, the checkpoints regulates the cell division. In cancer cell, the checkpoints are absent. That's the reason why, without any control, the cell division takes place in cancer cell. So, what I'm telling here, during cell division process, a group of checkpoints are there which are involved in the regulation of cell division. See, this is the concept, cell checkpoints, or cell cycle checkpoints. So, if the cell division occurs in a regulated manner, so the cell undergoes the normal cell division. If the cell involving uncontrolled cell division, that one is called as cancer cell, right? And coming to the, during cell division process, we know G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, and the mitotic phase. At which phases the checkpoints are present? At which phases the checkpoints are present? I like to discuss with the diagrammatic representation. We know already that cell cycle process. So, this is the one of the cell cycle. We know already this is the G1 phase. This is S phase. This is G2 phase. This is Young phase. So these are the phases we know. There is a G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase and M phase. Sir, in these phases, at which location checkpoints are present? Remember, the very first checkpoint is G1 phase checkpoint. This one is also called G1 and S phase checkpoint. This one is also called G1 and S checkpoint. See, this is the G1 phase and this is the S phase. Exactly here, one checkpoint is present. This is the checkpoint, right? This one is G1 and S phase. Between the G1 and S, there is a checkpoint is there. The checkpoint, okay, regulates. The checkpoint regulates or the checkpoint controls. See, all the conditions are maintained in G1 phase. All the conditions are maintained. Then the checkpoints allows to the entry of cell cycle into the next phase. Simple. If all the conditions are maintained in G1 phase, right, then the G1 phase enter into the S phase. If the conditions are not present, the cell division will be halted. So what I'm telling here, in the G1 phase, whatever the points we discussed, if all these conditions are maintained, the cell division enter into the S phase. If these conditions are not maintained, sir, what happened? The cell division will be halted. When the conditions are maintained, then the cell division enter into the next phase. The cell division enter into the next phase. There is nothing but G1 phase to S phase. So here there is a cell size, nutrients, yeah, cell size is increased or not. We already discussed that the cell organelles are doubled within that G1 phase. So cell size increased or not, checked by G1 phase checkpoint. Nutrients levels are present or not, checked by G1 phase checkpoint. Enzymes levels are present or not, checked by G1 phase checkpoint. ATP levels are raised or not, checked by G1 phase checkpoint. Is there any damaged DNA is present? The damaged DNA is repaired. We know about that car repair or vehicle repair, bike repair. So like that, when we are walking that time, maybe sometimes our cells are exposed to the UV rays, sudden DNA damages are happened. So in that case, we are not getting the cancer. Most of the people already know, sir, even midday we are walking, during summer also sometimes we went out to the sunlight at midday also. Sir, that time also we are not getting cancer. Why? Because we have that, the resistance given by the DNA repair mechanism. So the concept is very simple. When we are entered to the sunlight or when we are exposed to the UV rays, in that case, if our DNA is damaged, that time the damaged part deleted, right nucleotides are added. The process is called as DNA damage. The process is called as DNA repair mechanism. So The damaged DNA involved in the DNA repair mechanism. The concept is very simple. When we are entering to the sunlight, maybe sometimes we are exposed to the UV rays. That time, if our cells contains DNA is damaged, which are naturally repaired because we are having that repair mechanism system. So, during cell division process, in a cell, is there any damaged DNA is present? The damaged DNA is repaired. That one is called as DNA repair mechanism. That one is called as DNA repair mechanism. All of you remember, if all these are maintained in a cell, in G1 phase, then the cell is entered to the S phase. The cell is entered to the S phase. We know we are moving, we are traveling from here to Vizag. Okay, middle of the journey, okay, so many checkpoints are there. If we maintain all the things, then we allow to the next phase, means we allow to the Vizag. We allow to the Vizag, that is nothing but the people are allowed to cross the, whatever the toll gates are there, right? So the people are allowed. So here also, during the cell division process, there is a checkpoints are there, which are regulates entry of cell cycle from one phase to the another phase. So here, cell size, nutrients level, enzymes level, ATP level, DNA damaged, whatever the DNA damaged is there, or whatever that damaged part of the DNA is there, that one is repaired or not. If the repair is takes place, if the DNA repair mechanism activated, the repair process, okay, if the repair is completed, if the damaged DNA repaired, then the cell is entered to the G1 phase to S phase. Anyone is absent, ATP levels are absent, enzyme levels are absent, anyone is absent, the cell halted at G1 phase only. Sir, how the checkpoints are working? Very simple. This is one of the normal cell. This is the nucleus. This is the genetic material, right? So a group of proteins are present. These proteins are called as checkpoint proteins. So the checkpoint proteins are involved in the regulation of cell division, or which are involved in the checkpoints. Maintenance of checkpoints. So the concept is very simple. In a cell, a group of proteins are there during cell division process, which are regulates the cell division, or which are maintains the checkpoints, right? Sir, what about cancer cell? In cancer cell, the checkpoint proteins are absent. So checkpoint proteins are absent. There is no regulation. There is no checking process. So in cancer cell, absence of checkpoint proteins, uncontrolled cell division is takes place. In normal cell, presence of checkpoints, controlled cell division is takes place. Right? So that is about the G1 and S phase checkpoint. And coming to the next one is G2 phase checkpoint. This one is also called S and G2 phase checkpoint. See, during the cell division process, the DNA replication is completed or not. Some cases, is there any obstruction takes place, lack of raw materials or lack of anything, maybe sometimes DNA replication is halted. So, see, again a group of proteins are there which checks in a cell the DNA replication is completed or not, the 2N state genetic material produced 4N state or not. Checked by the G2 phase checkpoint, right? So checks the DNA replication. After the DNA replication, is there any damaged DNA present? So, is there any damaged DNA is present? The damaged DNA repaired. Right? So, what I'm telling here, DNA repair mechanism again activated after the G2 phase. After the S phase. So, this is one of the checkpoint exactly. This is one of the checkpoint in G2 phase. Here checks the DNA replication completed or not. Is there any damaged DNA is there? The damaged DNA checks and identifies, then repair its takes place. Right? So that is about the G2 phase checkpoint. And coming to the last checkpoint is the mitotic phase checkpoint. mitotic phase checkpoint. Sir, what is mitotic phase checkpoint? This one is also called M phase checkpoint. This one is also called M phase checkpoint. See, the M phase checkpoint occurs within that mitotic phase. That is nothing but within that mitotic phase, there is a prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Okay? Within these phases, exactly in metaphase, the checkpoint is chicks. The checkpoint chicks at which phase? Metaphase. This is the cell. These are the checkpoints, right? Within metaphase, the chromosomes are attached to the spindle apparatus or not? The chromosomes are attached to the, yeah, not like this, within metaphase. Within the metaphase, the chromosomes are attached to the spindle apparatus or not? Attached to the spindle apparatus or not? Checked by M phase checkpoint. So if the attachment is completed or not, checked by M phase checkpoint. Remember all of you, sister chromosomes are there. See, these chromosomes are called as sister chromosomes, right? See, the sister chromosomes are attached to the spindle apparatus or not, checked by the, M phase checkpoint. So what happens if the chromosomes are not attached? The cell division will be halted. So, sir, how the attachment takes place? We know the chromosomes contains one of that centromere. The centromere contains one of the kinetochore structure. That kinetochore structure supporting for the attachment of tubulin proteins. The tubulin proteins are nothing but spindle operators. So what happens if the attachment is not takes place? See, I already said, cell division will be halted. In some cases, during abnormal conditions, the cell division is occurred. Maybe the checkpoints are not active. The cell division is occurred. In that case, we know about there is a Klinefelter syndrome, Down syndrome. In some cases, number of chromosomes are decreased. We know about that 0.5% transgenders. See, normally we are having that 46 chromosomes. In certain cases, there is 47 chromosomes are there, X, Y, normal case. In abnormal case, X, X, Y. XXY or XXX, right? See, in some cases, one chromosome is absent. That is the 45 chromosomes are present. So due to the attachment, chromosomes are properly segregated. If the attachment is not properly takes place, if the checkpoint is not worked properly at that time, there is a chance for the generation of transgenders, right? So that is about that metaphase checkpoint. So this is about that regulation of cell division, especially here checkpoints which are involved in the cell division controlling process. So here G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase, the last one is the M phase. So exactly within that metaphase, the checkpoint 3 is present. So that is about that regulation. And remember, a group of proteins also involved in the regulation. I like to give that names also, sometimes asking the bits. See here that regulation, especially carried out by the cell division regulation, especially carried out by P53 protein, right? And next one, see, there is an CDK proteins are there, which are also involved in the regulation of cell division. Cell CDK, okay, cell dependent kinases, cell dependent kinases. So a group of CDK proteins which are involved in the regulation of cell division by cell dependent kinases. Along with that CDK proteins, some of cyclin A protein, cyclin B, cyclin C and cyclin D. These are the proteins also involved in the regulation of cell division. Cyclin A, cyclin B, cyclin C, cyclin D. These are the proteins also involved in the regulation of cell division. Remember, see P53 protein, sometimes P51 is also given, P53, right? Both these are correct, right? The P53 protein, CDK proteins, CDK means cyclin dependent kinases, cyclin A, cyclin B, cyclin C and cyclin D. See, if these two are combined, then cell division will be takes place. If these two are combined, means either CDK protein A or CDK protein B, CDK protein C, CDK protein D. See, if these two are combined, then the cell division will be takes place. So these two combinations, the CDK and cyclin proteins combination, regulates the cell division. That is about the cell cycle and the checkpoints, right? So that is about total cell cycle. From this area also some bits are given, which one regulates which one, right? See this checkpoint, okay? So here, which checkpoint identifies cell size increased or not, right? And which checkpoints identifies the chromosomes are attached to the spindle apparatus or not. So this kind of bits are given, okay? This is also very important concept, right? That is about the cell cycle and the checkpoints, right?